So today's lecture is on power systems. The code of the subject is EE352. So introduction of electrical power system. What basically a power system is? A power system is a combination of generation, transmission and distribution of electrical energy, that is electricity. So power and energy are the buzzword in today's world. As we all know, electricity is emerged as basic necessity with food, shelter and clothing for human beings. Life without electricity has become highly unimaginable. An electric locomotive, heating, cooling, fans, blowers, motors, illumination are some applications that converted electrical energy into useful work. The progress of any nation is measured in terms of per capita consumption of electrical energy, that is kWh consumed per person per year. kWh is the unit of electrical energy. As you see on this presentation, that India has a per capita consumption is 500 units or 500 kWh per person per year, as compared to the other nations like UK, where the consumption is 15 times that of India, and the US, that is 30 times that of India. So from this figure we can see that we can know that how we are lagging in our electrical generation of electrical energy and transmission and distribution, so as to the consumption of electrical energy. What are the reasons of popularity of electricity as compared to other energy sources? So the reasons are clean environment for users, higher efficiency, better controllability, quick transfer of power from source to load, energy conservation is simple. These are the few points which through which the electricity is popular as compared to other energy sources. This is a pictorial view of power system. In this particular slide, as you've seen here, it is a power station. The power station is here. The electrical energy is being generated with the help of either steam, water, nuclear energy, and then it will transfer through the transmission line. So this section, as we can see, this section is known as generation part of power system. Here this part is known as the transmission part. Transmission section, and this one from here to here, this will be the distribution section. Distribution of electrical energy. Energy is generated in generating stations, and a high voltage is being transmitted through the transmission line. Here you are seeing that 400 kV transmission line. Then it will be stepped down to 132 kV. These are the substations. These are the substations. Here, electricity is being generated on 11 kV. And then it will, with the help of this transformer, it will be converted from 11 kV to 400 kV. Then it will transfer for longer distance. This is a substation which is nearer to the load center. Here we step down the voltage from 400 kV to 132 kV with the help of this particular transformer, power transformer. Then from here, once again, the voltage level of electrical voltage level is being stepped down, say from 132 kV to 33 kV, and then it will send to the industries. It will send to the heavy industries, and the once again, as you see here, these are the distribution lines. Here the voltage level once again step down from 33 kV to 11 kV, and it will be given to the light industry. Then once again, from this section, from this here to here, as you see, this is known as the distribution section. So here the voltage level is, as compared to heavy industry or light industry, the requirement of voltage level is less, say 400 volt or 220 volt for the commercial and domestic purpose respectively. So once again we step down voltage from 11 kV to 400 volt, and subsequently here you can say this 440 volt to 220 volt, the single phase line is being used. So by this way the power is being transmitted from the generating station to the load center. These are the load centers. Say this is the heavy industry is a bulk consumer of electrical energy. Light industry, it is having the less power consumption as compared to the heavy industry. Heavy industries, you can say the cement industry, steel mills. The light industry, say oil mills. So these are the smaller types of industry, and these are the towns, villages, farms. So these are the residential section where the energy is being transmitted. So as we see, the power system has three major components. First is generation, transmission and distribution. And here the load centers. These are the load centers. This is a schematic diagram, a block diagram of power system. Now as we see in this slide that what is the power generation, current scenario of power generation in India. The facts are taken from the Ministry of Power website, Government of India, and these are the facts is of 30th April 2015. So as you see here that the thermal power, the current installed capacity in India of thermal power plant is 189,490 megawatt. The hydropower plant, the installed capacity is 41,632 megawatt. Nuclear power plant, it is 5,780 megawatt. And other sources are renewable sources like solar, wind, biomass, tidal, geothermal. So these are the other sources. From other sources in India we are getting the installed capacity is 35,777 megawatt. So in this manner the total installed capacity on April 2015 in India is 272,687 megawatt. The purpose of showing this slide is a very simple that in this slide, as you seen that the major portion is in India, we are getting electrical energy from the thermal power plant. Around 67% of electricity is being generated on thermal power plant. And as you aware that these conventional sources are being depleted day by day. So we have to increase, we have to decrease the dependency on these types of sources and increase the electricity production from renewable energy sources like solar, wind, biomass, tidal, etc. So as I have already discussed the sources of electrical power generation. So these are the sources of electrical power generation, the conventional sources like thermal, coal, nuclear, gas, water, or you can say hydro. Non-conventional energy sources are wind, solar, biomass, tidal, geothermal, etc. So, in previous slide as we have seen that we have to now decrease our dependency from conventional sources and we have to increase the power harnessing or electricity generation from the non-conventional sources. Now what are the disadvantages of conventional sources? So the disadvantage is, first one is fossil fuel self-depleted, forcing us to conserve them and find alternative resources like solar, wind, tidal, etc. The conventional sources are toxic, hazardous gases, residual, pollute environment. The overall conversion efficiency is very poor. As in case of thermal power plant, the energy is being the boiler efficiency which converts the water into steam, and for conversion we have to use coal to generate the heat. The conversion efficiency of boiler is around 35%. So by this manner you can compare that the overall conversion efficiency of conventional sources is very less. The sources are located in remote places with reference to load increase, which increase the transmission cost. As the coal is being, you have to transport the coal from the source location to the thermal power plant. So by this manner the transmission, it will increase the transmission cost. And one more thing, that is maintenance cost is high. The conventional sources, in case of conventional sources, maintenance cost is very high. So these are the few disadvantages of conventional sources. This is the block diagram of coal-fired thermal power plant. As in previous slide, we have seen that there are conventional power plants and non-conventional power plants. In case of conventional power plant, the major pipe is the thermal power plant. In case of thermal power plant, coal is being converted in, coal is being used to convert water into steam and this steam is used to generate electricity. So how this steam is used to generate electricity, that is being shown in this schematic diagram of coal-fired thermal station. So as you seen here, that this is the coal storage where the coal is being stored. That is the pulverizing mill where the coal is being crushed to the powder form. So it is crushed in such a manner that it will convert it into a fine powder, so that when we heat up, when we burn it, so the maximum surface area is being used, and it will convert the calorific value of this coal is being increased. This is the pulverizing mill. This is the boiler. These are the boiler tubes. Here, this is the steam turbine, which is connected to the boiler. This is cooling tower and condenser. This is the electrostatic precipitator. This is the air handling plant. Air storage. Here it is 3-phase AC generator, which is also known as alternator. And here the electricity is being generated in the range of 10 to 30 kV. Then circuit breaker, step up transformer, extra high voltage switchgear, and these are the primary bus, and here the extra high voltage transmission line. So now how this coal is being converted into coal is being burned, and the water is being converted into steam, and steam is being used to rotate the turbine. The turbine is connected to the alternator. So first, here the coal is stored. It will send to the pulverizing mill, where it is crushed in a powder form, as I have already told you. Here the coal is being sent to the boiler, where the coal is being burned and heat is produced. The heat, that heat is used to convert water into steam, a high pressure steam. Here the steam is being sent to the turbine with a very high pressure. So the turbine is being rotated. The alternator is connected to the turbine. So as the turbine is being rotated with the help of steam, the alternator is rotated, and the electrical energy is being produced here on the generating principle. Now the steam which strikes to the steam turbine, and it will discharge its energy on the steam turbine, and the remaining steam or discharge steam is being forwarded to cooling tower and condenser, where it is being cooled down. And one more thing is we can do here. This steam, this discharge steam is used to heat the water which will feed to the boiler. So as the discharge steam is also having some heat with it. So that heat is used to heat up the water before filling to the boiler. So the efficiency of boiler is being increased by doing this. The condenser is used to condense the discharge steam, and then it will discharge to the pond or reservoir situated near to the thermal power station. Why we are doing this? Suppose we discharge after striking the steam, it will discharge, and the discharge steam is spread to the environment. Then the temperature of nearby surroundings will increase drastically. So we have to cool it down to the general level, and then discharge it to the reservoir or pond. Same as here, in case of boiler, the core which is burned, the byproduct of this is ash, which is being sent to the air handling plant and air storage. So this is the byproduct. After air handling plant, there are some product is being manufactured with the help of this ash. Here, in case of this section, that is after generating the electricity, on the output of electrical energy is 10 kV to 30 kV. It will send to the circuit breaker. Then a step up transformer is being installed here. The step up transformer is stepping the voltage from say 11 kV to 400 kV. A EHV extra high voltage switchgear is used. It is a yard where from here the electricity is fed to the bus bar, and from this section the electricity is being transmitted over an extra high voltage transmission line. Now the coal based thermal power plant. India has rich stock of coal as natural resources. The chemical energy stored in coal is transferred to the electrical energy, as we have seen in previous slide. Coal powder is fired in boiler that converts water into steam at high temperature and high pressure. This steam is injected over the blades of steam turbine, is controlled in a controlled way, and hence rotor of three-phase AC generator rotates. So mechanical energy is being converted into electrical energy at a rated voltage say 10 to 30 kV. The used steam is cooled down to water using cooling towers and condensers. The preheated water is again injected in boiler tubes to convert back to steam. The fume gases are passed into atmosphere, and fine particles of ash are collected through electrostatic precipitator. The ash, which is the 40% of coal weight is collected and transported to the ash handling plant. So these are the process how the coal is being transported to the coal handling station or coal storage, and the electricity is being generated. Now the merits of coal based thermal power plant. Number one is coal is cheap and available in abundance at present. So here you can see it is written at present. Coal is cheap and available in abundance. Second, it is a time-tested process, so no experimentation is being required. Less space required as compared to hydro-based station, or less hazardous than nuclear power plant. Less initial cost as compared to other conventional process of power generation. These are the benefits, and now the demerits of coal power plant, the calorific value, that is kilocalorie per kg of Indian coal is very low and it is containing large ash content. The huge volume of ash produced daily and its disposal is a burning issue today. Atmospheric pollution is very high in case of coal-based thermal power plant. The transportation of coal to plant and transmission of generated power to the road center involves large expenses and large infrastructure is required for transmitting electrical energy from the load center, from the generated power to the load center. Next one is thermal power plant. So, in case of thermal power plant, huge amount of thermal energy is produced through nuclear fusion or fission process of radioactive element. This thermal energy is used to produce steam that can be utilized to rotate the turbine coupled to three-phase AC generator, which is known as alternator. Fusion is the process in which two lightweight nuclei combine to produce heavier nuclear, a neutron and a lot of exothermic energy. In fusion, deuterium and tritium nuclei are fused to produce heavy helium neutrons and 17.6 mega electrovolt of energy is being released. 1 gram of deuterium contains 1 lakh kilowatt hour, that is unit of energy, which is 10 million times that released by combustion of 1 gram of coal. Fission is the reaction in which heavy nucleus is split into two or more lighter nuclei, which release of neutrons, fission fragment, gamma rays, and a lot of thermal energy. Released neutrons have high kinetic energy and collides with other nucleus, resulting into secondary fission, which again produce same component as before. This process results into sustained chain reaction, producing huge amount of energy that can be utilized for producing steam that is subsequently used for rotating turbine. The main requirement of fission is such that the reaction should be self-sustained in nature. For self-sustained reaction, the substance should be fissile. It should not decay quickly and should be available in nature in moderate quantity. So all radioactive elements are fissile and satisfy the condition as specified for self-sustained reaction. Uranium-235 is commonly used for the process when it accepts neutron. It is fissioned into barium, krypton, neutrons, gamma rays and 200 mega electrovolt energy. All the time this huge heat energy is not required, and if it is not controlled, then it may result in a disaster. The speed of neutrons is controlled by moderator like graphite and heavy water to achieve critical speed of reaction. Furthermore, control rods like cadmium are placed between fuel rods that absorb neutrons for regulation of reaction, thereby to obtain control of generators. The control rods are pushed and pulled out to decrease and increase the power output respectively. So this is the process of how the electrical energy is being generated in a nuclear power plant. Here the control rods are necessary. So now the advantages of nuclear power generation. Number one is less quantity of fuel for generation of given amount of energy compared to other sources, as we have seen in previous slide, and higher reliability, efficient and less running cost. But it also having some disadvantages of nuclear power generation, that is fuel is expensive and not available in abundance everywhere. High capital cost is required, maintenance cost is very high, and nuclear waste disposal is a great problem. So these are the disadvantages of nuclear power plant or nuclear power generation. So this is the schematic diagram for nuclear power plant. This is the nuclear reactor. This is the coolant, hot, cold, heat exchanger, steam turbine, and from here onward, as we have seen in the thermal power plant side, the steam turbine is connected to the alternator, and the same mechanism is used for generating the electrical energy. So in nuclear reactor, these are the control rods, and this is the chamber where the nuclear fuel is being is used to generate the energy, thermal energy, either with the help of fusion or fission process. These are the control rods which is made of graphite or heavy water. It will control the reaction of nuclear substance. So in a controlled manner, the energy is being produced. If we insert it to the nuclear reactor, it will slow down the process by putting off. It will the process will increase. Now here the heat is being produced. It will send to the heat exchanger. So here the heat is transferred to the heat is transferred to the water, and water is being converted into high pressure steam. That high pressure steam is fall on the steam turbine, and the steam turbine is being rotated. The discharge steam which is converted into water with the help of condenser is once again fed to the heat exchanger, and this process is being followed. So this is the schematic diagram of nuclear power plant. Next is the schematic diagram of hydroelectric power plant. Here this is the reservoir, the dam, pressure tunnel, valve house, and that is the water turbine and generator. The dam is being used to store the huge amount of water, so that the head of water is kept maintained. Then from here the high pressure tunnel, the water is being discharged from here to here. So kinetic and potential energy is being converted into mechanical energy. Here the high pressure water with the help of penstock is flowing through from here to the generating station or water turbine. So as the water strikes to the water turbine, it will rotate, and the water turbine is coupled with the generator, AC generator. So the generator is being rotated, and electrical energy is produced as we have seen in previous slides. So as the water is strike on the turbine, it the potential energy is converted into rotating, it will rotate the turbine, and the remaining water is discharged to the tailway or reservoir. So hydroelectric power is generated by flow of water through turbine, turning the plates of the turbine. A generator shaft connected to this turbine also rotates and hence generates electricity. The major component of hydropower plants are dam or reservoir, large buffer tanks, penstock, which transfer the water from the dam to reservoir to the turbine station, powerhouse, which this incorporates the turbine, alternator, as you are seeing here, the turbine, water turbine, generator, and step up transformer. Depending on the capacity, hydropower plants are divided into following categories. So, large hydropower plant, the capacity is 50 megawatt to 1000 megawatt. Applications for distributing the power to the large city. Small hydropower plant from 1 megawatt to 50 megawatt. Mini hydropower plant 100 kilowatt to 1000 kilowatt. Micro, which is less than 100 kilowatt, and pico hydropower, which is less than 5 kilowatt. Yeah. You can say these are the seasonal power plants which will installed on a flowing river. So when the water is available, it will convert the energy into electrical energy. So hydropower plants are normally not in continuous operation mode and used for peak period during the day, like the VRs and the evening. Also, they are used when continuous operating thermal power plants go into overhauling. This is possible due to less startup time required by the hydropower plants. Hydropower power station, which is normally in few minutes as compared to thermal power plants, which is more than 8 hours. The command for starting or shutting down is issued from the related load dispatch center of particular region. The hydropower plants have efficiency of 75%. The power delivered is given by the following expression, that is power delivered is equal to 7 multiplied by H, which is the heads in meter, and equivalency rate of discharge in meter cubic meter per second. Advantages of hydropower plant. Once a dam is constructed, electricity is being produced at a constant rate. If electricity is not needed, the slight gate can be shut down, stopping electricity generation. The buildup of water in lay means that energy can be stored until needed. When the water is released to produce electricity, the lay water can be used for irrigation purpose. Hydropower plant is fueled by water, so it is a clean fuel source, and hydropower doesn't pollute the air like thermal power plants that burn fossil fuels such as coal, oil, or natural gases. But it is also having some disadvantage, like dams are extremely expensive to build and must be built to a very high standard. People in villages and nearby towns, they are in the valley to be flooded, must move out. So, rehabilitation is tedious thing here. Hydropower plants can be impacted by drought. When water is not available, the hydropower plant can't produce electricity. So these are the power plants. plant, a conventional power plant, thermal power plant, nuclear power plant and hydro